Good morning. Welcome to worship this morning. Please stand as you are able and join us in singing our gathering song, Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, found on the monitor screens in front of you. Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, early in the morning our song shall rise to thee. Holy, 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 merciful and mighty, God in three persons, blessed Trinity. Holy, 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 all the saints adore thee, casting down their golden crowns around the glassy sea. Cherubim and seraphim falling down before thee, which wert and art and evermore shalt be. Holy, 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 though the darkness hide thee, though the eye of sinfulness thy glory may not see, only thou art holy, there is none beside thee, perfect in power, in love and purity. Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, all thy works shall praise thy name in earth and sky and sea. Holy, 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 merciful and mighty, God in three persons, blessed Trinity.
Please be seated for a few announcements and welcome to worship at St. Stephen's on this Holy Trinity Sunday. It's a delight to have people here in the church, as well as those who join us via live stream. A few announcements. First, yesterday was an extremely important day because yesterday was Jane Severide's 100th birthday. Jane is the only person I know who is 100 years old, and I think that is really special. So we're going to sing Happy Birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jane. Happy birthday to you.
Bravo. What a gift to all of us. Okay, to more serious matters. I need to announce once more our special congregational meeting that will be held on June the 6th at 11:45 a.m. We will gather in person in the sanctuary here via Zoom and or by telephone. The only business to be conducted at this meeting will be the consideration of the motion recommended by the building renovation team and the Congregation Council, specifically that St. Stephen's Lutheran Church, it's not hire, we have to change that word, enter into a contract with Novak Design Group as our architect for phase one of two of a Place for Everyone, All Are Welcome building renovation project at a cost not to exceed $6,000 plus reimbursable expenses. And all voting members should have received a letter this week that gave that same information. Secondly, if you have any questions about this vote or any part of the renovation project, you are invited to join us for an information meeting to be held following our second service. That will be at 11:35. We will be outdoors, but you can also join by Zoom, and a Zoom link was sent yesterday, I believe, to everyone. So you have a choice how you want to participate. So that's the important one of the important announcements I need to make. Tomorrow is Memorial Day, and so I think it is fitting, before we enter into our worship, to ask you once again to stand as you are able, and we will observe a minute of silence to honor military personnel who have died fighting in wars. We will begin our worship now with confession and forgiveness. Please remain standing as you are able. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, full of compassion and mercy, abounding in steadfast love. Amen. Trusting God's promise of forgiveness, let us confess our sin against God and one another. God of mercy, we confess that we have sinned against you, against one another, and against the earth entrusted to our care. We are worried and distracted by many things. We fail to love you above all else. We store up treasures for ourselves and turn away from our neighbors in need. Forgive us, that we may live in the freedom of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. By grace we have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, our sins are forgiven. We are now at peace with God, whose love is poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit breathed into us. Rejoice in this good news. We continue with the Kyrie.
Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. We pray for peace from above. We pray for our salvation. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. We pray for peace in the world. We pray for wellness in your church. We pray for the unity of all. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. We pray for this holy place. We pray for all who gather here. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Oh Lord, help us, save us. Oh Lord, comfort and defend us. Amen. Glory in the highest, glory be to God. Glory in the highest, and peace to all the earth. Glory in the highest, glory be to God. Glory in the highest, and peace to all the earth. Shaper of the universe, thanks and praise we sing. Loving Father, caring Mother, hold us in your wings. Glory in the highest, glory be to God. Glory in the highest, and peace to all the earth. Glory in the highest, glory be to God. Glory in the highest, and peace to all the earth. Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, you wash our sins away. At your table, all are welcome. Hear us as we pray. Glory in the highest, glory be to God. Glory in the highest, and peace to all the earth. Glory in the highest, glory be to God. Glory in the highest, and peace to all the earth. Holy Spirit, source of life, burning wild and free. You are God, the three in one, such a mystery. Glory in the highest, glory be to God. Glory in the highest, and peace to all the earth. Glory in the highest, glory be to God. Glory in the highest, and peace to all the earth.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Almighty Creator and ever-living God, we worship your glory, eternal three in one, and we praise your power, majestic one in three. Keep us steadfast in faith, defend us in all adversity, and bring us last into your presence, where you live endless joy and love, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
You may be seated, and at this time I would like to invite any children who wish to come up here for a little message. Okay, good morning. And we have Saint Ethan and Saint Lauren with us this morning. And I know that Saint Genevieve is here too, and we have some visitors, but I don't know their names. And I don't think they're being a little shy, and that's okay. But yes, I kind of figured Mommy had to change Genevieve's diaper. That happens. So today is called Holy Trinity Sunday. And that's a really big idea, Trinity. It sounds, the beginning of it, T-R-I, is like tricycle. What is a tricycle? A bike with three wheels, yes. And so that T-R-I always means three. And so Trinity is one of the ways we talk about God, and it's a little bit complicated. you will hear me say things like the Holy Trinity, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. And sometimes we also talk about Creator, Sustainer, Redeemer, or, you know, those kind of language. But so here's a picture of one way that we can help ourselves understand about the Trinity. You can see it's an apple, and it's been cut in half. And the outside of the apple, you know, the skin, is like God. And like the skin, you know, the skin of the apple holds it all together, and it protects the inside of the apple. So God is kind of like that, God the Father. That's the name of the little girl who drew this diagram, which I think is Lillian. Anyway, so the flesh, the part of the apple that we eat, that we really enjoy, that's called the flesh. And the flesh is kind of like Jesus, who is the Word made flesh, right? He's the one that fills everything that God has created. And then in the middle, we have these seeds. And the seeds are kind of like the Holy Spirit who gives life, right? So when you think about seeds and we plant them, what happens? New things grow, right? So I don't know how much that helps, but it is one way to talk about the Trinity. So, but you remember the names of the Trinity, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, right? Yeah, that's good. And I did put some coloring pages at the back, but I have some more up here, so I will give you a couple more of those, okay? Would you like to have some? Okay, good. There you go, and thank you so much for coming to church today. All right. Okay, we continue with our reading. From Romans chapter 8, verses 12 through 17, St. Paul writes, "Brothers and sisters, we are debtors, not to the flesh, to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. For all who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you received a spirit of adoption. When we cry, Abba, Father, it is the very Spirit bearing witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ, if in fact we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him." Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Alleluia.
The Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you. Glory to you, glory to you, O Lord. Glory to you, glory to you, glory to you, O Lord.
Now there was a Pharisee named Nicodemus, a leader of the Jews. He came to Jesus by night and said to him, "Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher who has come from God, for no one can do these signs that you do apart from the presence of God." Jesus answered him, "Very truly I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God without being born from above." Nicodemus said to him, How can anyone be born after grown old? Can one enter a second time into a mother's womb and be born? Jesus answered, "Very truly I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God without being born of water and spirit. What is born of the flesh is flesh, and what is born in the spirit is spirit. Don't be astonished, and that I said to you, you must be born from above. The wind blows where it chooses, and you hear the sound of it, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is where everyone who is born the Spirit." Nicodemus said to him, "How can these things be?" Jesus answered, "Are you a teacher of Israel, and yet you do not understand these things? Very truly I tell you, we speak of what we know and testify to what we have seen, yet you do not receive our testimony. If I have told you about earthly things and you do not believe, how can you believe if I tell you about heavenly things? No one has ascended into heaven except the one who descended from above, the Son of Man. And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world may be saved through him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
Be seated. Last Sunday, we all dressed up in red and celebrated the Holy Spirit descending to us and manifesting in us by the speaking of the tongues. I found that especially curious, since in our reading of the Tower of Babel up in the Old Testament, we get scattered because we are speaking the same language and conspiring to build this really tall tower. But this is different. We have the Holy Spirit manifesting to us and helping us communicate each other and pulling together. I bring last week's lesson into today because I have a thing for the Holy Spirit. Anyone that has come in contact with them have actually gone out for a wild ride. I would dare to say that a good chunk of the things that we do are inspired by the Holy Spirit. And by that I mean whatever good we do to the other person, the one next to us. The Holy Spirit is the less mentioned person in the whole Bible. And the Trinity of the Holy Trinity. And this is what we're celebrating today. When I was living in Jersey, one of my best friends was a Muslim. And we'd actually argue heatedly during our breaks, and people will think that we're fighting. We're not. But we spend a lot more time defending our faith than we spend attacking the other. And he actually knew my weak spot. He knew my kryptonite, which was the Holy Trinity, trying to explain the Holy Trinity in rational thought. So whenever he just didn't want to argue anymore, he'll be like, "Oh, what about the Holy Trinity?" I'm like, "Okay, I'm tapping out." I kind of like the analogy of the apple. I was thought one different, and it was really cute. It was a flower. So you have a flower, and you have the petals, you have the stem, and you have the leaves. It's on one flower, but it's three different things. So basically, that's a cute explanation for the trilogy that anybody with personal rational thought would be like, "Well, it's not a flower, though." But I have been really active in my faith in the past, and right now I'm even more active, and in the future I'm hoping that I'm more active than I am right now. But that's the one thing that I've always, and probably will always, have trouble explaining rationally the Holy Trinity. I could think about them individually. I can talk about the Father that loves me enough to give His Son for my sins, and about the Spirit that guides my step to help everyone I come across. But how could I say these three persons are one God without falling into the dangers of polytheism? The Apostle Paul talks in his letter to the Romans very distinctively. First of all, he calls us to recognize that we have an obligation, but he makes sure that we understand that obligation is not with the flesh. It's an obligation towards the Spirit. How is it that he makes that distinction? Why is it that he makes the distinction? I want to dissect that a little bit. It's fun how in the letter he refers to each person of the Trinity separately. First, he talks about the Father. He doesn't mention the Father directly, but he addresses us by calling us children of God. Because we are led by the Spirit of God, then he moves to explain that the Spirit makes us free, and we are not to feel as if we're slaves. I'm thinking that slaves live in fear of their masters, but the Spirit is freeing us, but from what? Now, on the reading, we see that the Spirit is actually spelled out in capital letters. If I'm talking about a spirit, it would probably be lowercase, but it's actually spelled out as a name. What about the Son? Well, the Spirit makes us free so we can share the same space as the Son, and we are offered sonship. The Greek word for sonship is hypothesia, and I hope the Greek scholar doesn't kill me over the pronunciation, but it actually means placing as a son, and it's mentioned only 5 times in the whole Bible. And every time that it's mentioned, it describes what God has done for his people, but what has he really done for us? For me. For you. And subsequently, for the world. In the Gospel, we find Nicodemus, which is part of the Sanhedrin or the Jewish Council, Jewish ruling council. The Sanhedrin is the top religious body of the Jewish nation, and he comes to Jesus at night. Why is this important? Well, we can speculate. First of all, there were 2 Sanhedrins. The Sanhedrin had 23 judges per city. And then you had the Great Sanhedrin, which had 71 judges and acted as kind of a supreme court. Maybe Nicodemus went to him at night because he didn't want to be seen by anyone because of his post of importance. Maybe he was a really busy man and only had time to go and see Jesus at nighttime. But John gives us a good idea in chapter 7 as to why. In John 7:45 to 52, we see that the Pharisees were against Jesus and were applying pressure on members that were starting to believe in him. So it's a little logical to think that he was probably not wanting to get seen, avoiding the pressure. The point is that he comes to Jesus and calls him Rabbi, recognizes that Jesus comes from God, and gives him a reason why he knows he is from God. Jesus then starts to tell Nicodemus that no man can see the kingdom of heaven unless they are born again. Nicodemus instantly starts going on with his human mind and asks how anyone can be truly born again if they are old. We are born again every day. We are born again every day and multiple times. We are given so many chances to be born again. When we see someone starving and begging for food. When we second guess ourselves when we see that beggar at a traffic light. Every time we have to make a choice whether to help someone or not, we are given a chance to be born again. Some of them, brothers and sisters, use the term as something that we all have to do, be born again, Jesus, so we have to be born again in order to be saved. Again, we're born again every day. You cannot say that you have accepted Jesus and you are born again when you turn a blind eye to someone in need. You cannot say that you are born again in Jesus when you see someone with disabilities trying to get into a building and not hold open the door for them, which is in terms of what we're trying to do as St. Stephen's, creating a space where all are welcome to worship and grow and just to be accepted. A place where the color of your skin, your ethnic background, your sexual orientation are not important. They are part of your personality. They are part of who you are, and you are a beloved child of God, and we love you for them, but it do not define you. Back to the gospel. Nicodemus is trying to get Jesus to explain to him why he can and how he can be born again, and I feel it was more of a tongue-in-cheek type thing. He said, "You're an Israel's teacher, and you don't understand these things." Jesus foreshadows the crucifixion, talking to Nicodemus by saying, just as Moses lifted up the snake in the wilderness, the Son of Man must be lifted up that everyone believes and may have eternal life in him. Just then, we see the Holy Trinity again. We see a loving Father who is giving his Son to be lifted up so we all can be inspired by the Spirit and believe in the Son so we may have eternal life. The thing is, we are loved by the one God that is three persons, and each person loves us in a different way. We have three ways that we can learn to love one another. Can you think of multiple ways to love your brother and or sister? We continue with the hymn of the day.
Upon the waters, you have sung in the rush of wind and flame, and in your love you have called us sons and daughters, us people of the water and your name. Come fill our waiting hearts with the Spirit of Jesus. Let us shine with your light and peace. God, you have moved upon the waters. You have sung in the rush of wind and flame, and in your love you have called us sons and daughters. Make us people of the water and your name. Give us a thirst for love. Give us a hunger for justice. Make us one with the mind of Christ. God, you have moved upon the waters. You have sung in the rush of wind and flame. And in your love you have called sons and daughters. Make us people of the water and your name. You are the breath of life. You are the hope of the hopeless. Come and fill us light and peace. God, you have moved upon the waters. have sung in the rush of then flame, and in your love you have called us sons and daughters. Make us people of the water and your name. Come open every heart, come now and wake us to wonder. Make us vessels of light and peace. God, you have moved upon the waters. You have sung in the rush of wind and flame, and in your love you have called us sons, daughters. Make us people of the water and your name. Make us people of the water and your name.
Our faith, using these words from the Iona Abbey Worship Book. We believe in God above us, maker and sustainer of all life, of sun and moon, of water and earth, of male and female. We believe in God beside us, Jesus Christ, the Word made flesh, born of a woman, servant of the poor, tortured and nailed to a tree. A man of sorrows, he died forsaken. He descended into the earth to the place of death. On the third day, he rose from the tomb. He ascended into heaven to be everywhere present, and his kingdom will come on earth. We believe in God within us, the Holy Spirit of Pentecostal fire, life-giving breath of the church, spirit of healing and forgiveness, source of resurrection and eternal life. Amen.
The Spirit intercedes for us with sighs too deep for words to express all.
We pray, O God, for your holy church around the world. Revitalize and renew us, that we may be reborn once again through the waters of baptism and the blowing wind of your Spirit. We pray for this worshiping community, that the splendor of your majesty and the holiness of your mystery may be glorified through our worship and our relationships with one another.
The Spirit intercedes for us with sighs too deep for words to express all. We
give you thanks for your power revealed to us in creation, for cedar and oak trees, for rushing waters, for the echoes of thunder. We pray for the nations and our leaders, that led by your Spirit, they work towards a world where all of your children enjoy peace.
The Spirit intercedes for us with sighs too deep for words to express all.
We pray for healing for all those who suffer, especially victims and survivors of trauma and or violence. Give respite to those living with PTSD and other mental health concerns. Comfort and strengthen all who are named on our prayer list and in the silence of our hearts. We give you thanks, O God, for those who have died in faith. We remember also those whose lives have been lost due to the horrors of war.
The Spirit intercedes for us with sighs too deep for words to express all.
We lift our prayers to you, O God, trusting in your abiding grace. Amen.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us exchange COVID protocol signs of peace. Peace. At this time, we will participate in God's work here at St. Stephen's and in the world through the offering of our gifts. And we are especially grateful for the generous commitments and gifts we have received for our building renovation project. And as the offering is taken, we will sing together, "We Are an Offering."
We lift our voices, we lift our hands, we lift our lives up to you, we are an offering. Lord, use our voices, Lord, use our hands, Lord, use our lives, they are yours, we are an offering. All that we have, all that we are, all that we hope to be, we give to you, we give to you. We lift our voices, we lift our hands, we lift our lives up to you, we are an offering, we are an offering.
Please stand and let us pray together. Blessed are you,
O God, for the greening of the earth given for all, for the talents we are given to share, and for this bread and wine. Transform us to be the body of Christ, that feasting on this food and drink, our lives may reflect your generosity through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is our duty and delight that we should everywhere and always offer thanks and praise to you, O God, through Jesus Christ, who with you and the Holy Spirit is worshiped and glorified, one God, holy and eternal. And so with the church on earth, all creation and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy,
breath of life and fire of love, with a mighty wind you brought creation into being, and by a pillar of fire you led your people into freedom. We praise you for the gift of your Son, who poured out your Spirit on his disciples of every race and nation. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his death, resurrection, and the sending of the Holy and life-giving Spirit, we await his coming again to renew the face of the earth. Send now your Holy Spirit upon us and upon this meal. Anoint us with your gifts of faith, hope, and love, that with thankful hearts we may be witnesses to your Son. Through him, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, both now and forever.
Amen.
Amen. Let us pray as Jesus taught us.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
The risen Christ invites all who are present to this table of bounty. Come, the banquet is ready. And just as a reminder, we are doing our circle dance where everybody is going to come up from this aisle. I will be stationed here with the bread. Will be over here with the little cups of wine. And there is a basket for your empty glass. We are practicing, our practice here is that if we are closer than the regulation 6 feet, we encourage you to wear your mask. So when I give you the bread, step a few feet past me before you lift your mask to receive the bread. Okay.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy, mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy, mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Oh, grant us peace, Lamb of God. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Oh, grant us peace, Lamb of God. Thank you.
and fill our hearts with your peace. You alone, O Lord, are holy. Come and fill our hearts with your peace. Alleluia. Come and fill our hearts with your peace. You alone, O Lord, are holy. Come and fill our hearts with your peace. Alleluia.
Please stand and let us pray together. Oh God, in this holy communion, you have welcomed
us into your presence, nourished us with words of mercy, and fed us at your table. Amid the cares of this life, strengthen us to love you with all our heart. Serve our neighbors with a willing spirit, and honor the earth you have made. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Live your lives in Christ, rooted and built up in our Savior, abounding in thanksgiving, and the blessing of the Holy Trinity, one God, be upon you and remain with you forever. Amen.
Come join the dance of Trinity before our world begun. The interweaving of the three, the Father, Spirit, Son. The universe of space and time did not arise by chance. But as the three in love and hope made room within their dance, come see the face of Trinity, newborn in Bethlehem. Then bloodied by a crown of thorns outside Jerusalem, the dance of Trinity is meant for human flesh and bone. When fear confines the dance in death, God rolls away the stone. Come speak aloud of Trinity as wind and tongues of flame. Set people free at Pentecost to tell the Savior's name. We know the yoke of sin and death, our necks have worn it smooth. Go tell the world of weight and woe that we are free to move. Within the dance of Trinity, before all worlds begun, we sing the praises of the three, the Father, Spirit, Son. Let voices rise and interweave, by love and hope set free. To shape in song this joy, this life, the dance of Trinity.
Go in peace, know, live, and share Christ. Thanks be to God. Hallelujah.